These are photos from my personal collection. They're all silver nitrate photos on archival fiber base paper, double weight. Most of them were printed from the original negatives. A lot of these are FSA photos, and there's a lot of other things here too. These are 11 by 14, always an 8 by 10. I actually have one of these signed by Gordon Parks. Not sure where it is these days, but my wife went ahead and had it signed for me. I've got a book of his somewhere too that's signed. Here's a nice FSA from the original negative. Really rich tones on these, and just a gorgeous luster. Looks like this one I sepia toned back in the day. I have a couple of selenium toned photos too. And these Curtis negatives, this one is just absolutely gorgeous. Look at that beautiful tone on these. Beautiful master prints. This one's a little flatter than I'd like it. A lot of these, I was working towards perfection, dodging and burning out usually at different grades, doing a lot of pulling every trick in the book. That one, I believe, is sepia tone. That one's not tone. These are Ansel Adams negatives. All these were done from original negatives. Curtis was from a copy negative off a master print. More sepia tone. FSA from the original negatives. This one's a little too flat, a little too light. Sepia tone. That one I believe is selenium tone. These are from the Look collection, like the young Stanley Kubrick there. But again, these are printed from original negatives. John Muir. These will never again be printed photographically from the original negatives. These are really unique. Really an amazing collection. Signed photos. It's a little more burned in than the other. A lot of detail in these photos. Diane Arbus. That was from a copy negative, that not from the original. These are original negatives. All of these hand-printed, washed, archivally washed. Think of the crazy number of hours that went into printing these. Didn't work from test strips. I was able to read the contrast and the density of a negative and make a pretty good test print right off the bat. And from there, I would determine where I need to go to make a master print. I was an incredible darkroom technician back in the day. I wonder if I had a darkroom, whether I still had it. Because I was really a master printer. Just the 11 by 14 fiber base, but you get an idea of what the collection I have looks like.